Today, I want to share with you guys my favorite test question for my precalculus class and also trig class. And if you're also a math teacher, then please feel free to use this question on your test as well. This is how it goes. First, I'm going to give them a triangle, and you have to make sure that one of the angles is bigger than 90 degrees. So of course, this is the one that's bigger than 90 degrees. And I'm going to give them all three sides. This side right here is 3, this side right here is 3.9, and this side right here is the longest side, which is 5.8. And now, because we have all three sides, so in fact, we can just use the law of cosine to solve the triangle, meaning find out all the missing angles. But wait, this is what I will do. I'm going to give them one of the smaller angles. Let's say this one right here. I will tell them that this right here is 28.25 degrees. And the question is, I will ask them to find out the biggest angle, which is this one right here. I'm just going to label this as C. So you know, please pause the video and try to find out what angle C is. So here's the deal. Because I gave you guys this angle as well, as you can see, we have side angle. So in fact, we can just use the law of sine as well. And here we go. Here is the angle C. I will label this as side C. And then I'm just going to call this angle A. And I'll just call this side A. And law of sine says sine A over little a equals sine C over C. And then plug in the numbers and solve it, right? Let me put this down right here first. Right here we have sine C over its corresponding side, which is 5.8. And then that should be equal to sine of angle A, which is 28.25 degrees. And then we have to divide that by its corresponding side, which is just a 3. And to solve for C, first we multiply the 5.8 on both sides, and then take the inverse sine so that we can get rid of the original sine. This tells us that angle C is equal to inverse sine of 5.8 right here, times sine of 28.25 degrees, and then all divided by 3. And now this is the time that we can just use the calculator, enter everything on the calculator, and make sure your calculator is in the degree mode. We will get measured angle C being equal to, ready? 66.2 degrees, and I should say approximately equal to. All right, done deal, box the answer and get this question wrong. Why? Because we can clearly see that from the picture, this angle has to be bigger than 90 degrees. Yeah? Or do you think that we should really just trust the computation and don't worry about the picture? Maybe I just drew a really bad picture. What do you think? Well, I told you guys earlier that because we have all three sides, so in fact, we could also have used the law of cosine to help us out. So let's try that as well. So this right here is for the LOC, namely law of cosine, which says this little c right here, if you square that, it's equal to a square, and I'm just going to call this little b right here. So little b square, right? And if I just stop right here, then this is of course the Pythagorean theorem. However, if we do not have a right triangle, the Pythagorean theorem doesn't hold. This is not a right triangle, so we will have to look at this as minus 2ab times cosine of this side's corresponding angle, so it's cosine C. I will say this is like the more complete version of the Pythagorean theorem because it works for all triangles. And you use this whenever you are given all three sides. Now, let's go ahead and solve for angle C first before we plug in the numbers. I'm going to move this to the other side and then move the C square to the other side. And we get 2ab cosine C equals a squared plus b squared and then minus c squared. Then I will divide both sides by 2ab, then take the inverse cosine on both sides. And we will get angle C being equal to inverse cosine of these three things, a squared plus b squared minus c squared over 2ab, like this. and then we plug in the numbers. One really common mistake is that students tend to forget to put a big parenthesis around here on the top and then a big parenthesis around the bottom. Work this out, and again, make sure your calculator is in the degree mode. This time though, we'll see angle C is approximately equal to 113.8 degrees. So now, which one do you believe? Of course, this one, right? Angle C is 113.8 degrees, and you can see that much better from the picture here. So now the question is, what's going on? How come the law of sine didn't give us the correct answer? Well, I'll tell you. Unfortunately, the inverse sine function, it has its limitation. And that is the range of the inverse sine function. Here is the deal. If we are looking at y equals inverse sine x, this right here, it has its range going from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2, namely negative 90 degrees to positive 90 degrees. So if you are trying to figure out a missing angle by using the law of sine, if the angle is bigger than 90 degrees, unfortunately, the inverse sine will not give you the answer right away, because the biggest answer that this function can give you is positive 90 degrees. As opposed to if we use the inverse cosine function, I will write that down right here as well. If we are looking at inverse cosine, then the range for this thing here, in fact, it goes from 0 to pi, and that is from 0 degrees to 180 degrees. So if you're trying to look for an angle that's bigger than 90 degrees, then law of cosine will give you the answer right away, just like exactly what we did right here. All right, so that answers the question, but what does a 66.2 represent? Can we still somehow make this work? Of course, the answer to that is yes, it's possible. The quick way to do this is like this. If you know the angle is for sure bigger than 90 degrees, but the answer does not give you the number bigger than 90 degrees, then you do this. Subtract this number from 180 degrees. If you work this out, you will see that C is approximately, yes, 113.8 degrees. And now they are the same. Anyway though, here's the deal. You see that this side right here is 3. I'm going to extend A and C right here like this. Now, this is 3. In fact, you can kind of rotate it. Then you can also see that we can form another triangle like this right here, because this rib segment, it's also 3. The 66.2 degrees is in fact this angle here, 66.2 degrees. And because this red side and this side right here, they are the same, so that means this angle will also be 66.2 degrees. Now, how do we figure out this angle? This angle will just be 180 degrees minus 66.2 degrees, isn't it? Yes. And if you do that, you end up with the correct answer. Hey everyone, I'm excited to tell you about Brilliant.Work, our sponsor for today's video. As a math teacher, I know firsthand how important it is for students to have access to quality resources to help them learn effectively. And that's exactly what Brilliant provides. Their courses are designed to make learning interactive and engaging. Their trig and precalculus classes, in particular, are built around visual and physical intuition, which makes it easy for students to understand tricky concepts like the sine cosine functions. And the best part is, each lesson is fun because they will have storytelling and animations that bring material to life. And what sets Brilliant apart is the approach to problem solving. They don't just teach students how to memorize formulas, they give them the tools they need to solve problems on their own. So if you're looking for a fun and effective way to learn trick, then definitely check out Brilliant. Use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen, and you can get a 20% off discount. And right now they also offer a 30-day free trial. So definitely go check them out and start learning today. I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video, and I also want to thank you guys for checking them out.